the RCA Victor Special Model K. This is an incredible phonograph, and every once in a while you'll see one, but if you do, they're never for sale. So cool.
John Vassos.
I know. It's bad to the bone. John Vassos was an industrial designer that designed anything from paring knives to shotguns. But his relationship with RCA spanned 40 years. He designed televisions, he designed radios, and he designed this phonograph.
The greatest thing about knuckleheads, their overhead valves, they started making them in 1936 to 1947. You know, when they describe Harley-Davidson motorcycles, it's all about the top end. When they call them panheads, the top of the rocker boxes look like soup pans. Knuckleheads look like two knuckles coming up like that.
Through the inventions of science, I can make my solemn act of dedication with a whole empire listening. I should like to make that dedication now. It is very simple. I declare before you all that my whole life, whether it be long or short, shall be devoted to your service and to the service of our great imperial family to which we all belong.
Back in London in July 1947, Elizabeth and Philip were finally able to make their engagement public. Churchill spoke for many when he said the wedding would be a flash of color on the road we have to travel.
It was all rather drab. And then this very beautiful young princess, the heir to the throne, marries a very dashing, very handsome officer in the Royal Navy. And it was a moment of national rejoicing which was beyond the war.
The royal wedding took place at Westminster Abbey.
Judging by the expression that we could just about see when they left St. Edward's Chapel and came down into the sanctuary and then started their procession at the end, they were very happy about it all. Certainly some big broad smiles. Not just to their friends either. It seemed to be everybody included.
Lady Butter was inside the Abbey as an old friend of the royal couple. Then she hurried to Buckingham Palace to enjoy being part of the crowd.
Thousands of people by then, all singing and shouting. But it was a long, long wait because they were obviously having their wedding breakfast.
They cheered the happy pair when they came out onto the balcony. What a wonderful picture the princess made, looking most lovely in her magnificent gown and standing happily beside her husband.
Lucky her, I think we thought, and lucky all of us, frankly. Because, you know, it was a really good fairy tale, and it's remained a good fairy tale, too.
But the domestic idyll of married life would be all too brief for the newlyweds. Soon, duty would beckon.
On this day in 1947, Harry Truman dedicated the Everglades National Park in Florida, protecting more than 2,000 square miles of wetlands and wildlife.
Across the alley from the Alamo lived a pinto pony and a Navajo who sang a sort of Indian idaho to the people passing by. The pinto spent his time a-swishing flies and the Navajo watched the lazy skies, and very rarely did they ever rest their eyes on the people passing by. One day they went a-walking along the railroad track. They were swishing, not a-looking. Toot, toot, they never came back. Oh, across the alley from the Alamo, when the summer sun decides to settle low, a fly sings an Indian hearty-ho to the people passing by. Across the alley from the Alamo lived a pinto, a pony, and a Navajo who
used to bake friolis and cornmeal dough for the people passing by. They thought that they would make some easy bucks by washing their friolis in Dove and Lux. A pair of very conscientious clucks to the people passing by. Then they took this cheap vacation. The shoes were polished bright. No, they never heard the whistle. Toot, toot. They're clear out of sight. Oh, across the alley from the Alamo, when the starlight beams its tender glow, the beans go to sleep and then there ain't no dough for the people passing by. One day they went a-walking along the railroad track. They were swishing, not a-looking, toot, toot. They never came back. Oh, across the alley from the Alamo, when the summer sun decides to settle low, a fly sings an Indian hidey-ho to the people passing by. Across the alley from the Alamo.
One night Farmer Brown was taking the air, locked up the barnyard with the greatest of care. Down in the hen house something stirred when he shouted, "Who's there?" This is what he heard: "There ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. So calm yourself and stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. We chickens trying to sleep and you butt in and hobble, 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 hobble with your chin. There ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. You're stomping around and shaking the ground. You're kicking up an awful dust. We chickens trying to sleep and you butt in and hobble, 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 hobble. It's a sin. Tomorrow is a busy day. We got things to do. We got eggs to lay. We got ground to dig and worms to scratch. It takes a lot of setting, getting chicks to hatch. Oh, there ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. So quiet yourself and stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. Kindly point that gun the other way and hobble, hobble, hobble off and hit the hay. To do, we got eggs to lay, we got ground to dig and worms to scratch. It takes a lot of setting, getting chicks to hatch. There ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. So quiet yourself and stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. And kindly point that gun the other way and hobble, hobble, hobble off and hit the hay. Hey, hey, boss man, what do you say? It's easy pickings, there ain't nobody here but us chickens.
This has been, what a rare mood I'm in. Why, it's almost like being in love. There There's a smile on my face for the whole human race. Why, it's almost like being in love. All the music of life seems to be like a bell that is ringing for me. And from the way that I feel when that bell starts to peal, I would swear I was falling. I could swear I was falling. It's almost like being in love. Music of life seems to be like a bell that is ringing for me. And from the way that I feel when that bell starts to peal, I would swear that I'm falling. I could swear I was falling. It's almost like being in love. In fact, I have fallen in.